includes climate adaptive agriculture, health and nutrition, among others. NITI Aayog has the mandate of overseeing the adoption and monitoring of SDGs at the national and subnational level. Progress in the northeastern region is crucial in this decade of action for the country to achieve the SDGs by 2030. This conclave is part of the NITI Aayog's continuous efforts towards fostering partnerships at the subnational level. Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that India's diversity fills each and every countryman with a sense of pride, sharing his thoughts on the 62nd episode of Mann Ki Baat program on All India Radio yesterday. The Prime Minister said the expanse and diversity of the nation is a source of inspiration for the citizens. Mr. Modi appealed to the people to pick up activity of their interest and integrate their lives with adventure. He also said India's children and youth are increasingly taking a keen interest in science and technology. Mr. Modi recalled that when he was in Bengaluru during the launch of Chandrayaan 2, he witnessed immense enthusiasm on the part of the children present there. The Prime Minister exuded pride that women in New India are taking on new challenges and setting a pace for positive transformation in society. Mr. Modi also gave the example of 105-year-old Bhagirathi Amma from Kollam in Kerala, who restarted her school education despite her advanced age. Ahead of the start of the second part of Parliament's budget session, Sikkim's lone Lok Sabha member Indra Hang Subba has stressed on the need to improve the quality of debate in the House. Subba, one of the youngest MPs in Parliament, said MPs should stop using abusive language and that the debate should be issue-based without attacking members of other parties personally. Subba said sometimes during the debate he saw some of the colleagues crossed the limit and made abusive statements to their colleagues from the other party. The MP said that the quality of debate should be a little higher than the level we are at present. Whether the northeastern region is still neglected by the central government, Subba said, the issues are not listened to in a proper manner. The second leg of the budget session of Parliament will commence from March 2 to April 3. Tunnel number 4 of the Jiribam-Imphal railway line was inaugurated by Railway Board Chairman V.K. Yadav at Marangching village. The tunnel is 2,265 meters long and is the second longest tunnel connecting Tupul and Imphal. There are 7 tunnels in total. The remaining tunnels would be completed soon, Yadav said. He informed that around 90% of the work has been completed and exuded confidence that the work will be complete by the new deadline of March 2022. At least 77 people have been arrested in drug and alcohol-related cases in Mizoram, an official of the State Excise and Narcotics Department said yesterday. Various drugs and illicit alcohol, including 312.75 grams of heroin, 505 grams of cannabis, and 404 tablets of another drug, tramadol, were seized during raids conducted in last 1 week. Spokesperson of the Excise and Narcotics Department, Peter Zomingthanga, said. He said that 1,179.25 litres of locally brewed alcohol, or rugzu, and a large quantity of IMFL were also seized during the raids. At least 16 illegal liquor manufacturing units were destroyed at Punchwang area on the outskirts of Aizawl during the raid on Saturday. Meanwhile, the Narcotics and Excise Department has cautioned people against consumption of locally brewed liquors as spurious ingredients are used to manufacture the products. And with that, we in the Northeast News Bulletin, which came to you from All India Radio, Shillong. Have a nice day.